positive.
Shalom.
Shalom.
All right, we're the brothers from the GMS Atlanta Church. Back on another Saturday to do another edifying lesson. Lord willing, y'all truly edifying. First off, we want to give all praises, all honor and glory to
Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, Kadosh.
Double honors to the apostles and elders, the great millstone who rule and teach well, who also taught us this 100% truth. Shalom to the hopeful elect. All right, so we're just going to get straight into it, dealing with prophecy and dealing with World War III, which, you know, we've been starting with our elders and apostles, great millstone. We've been prophesying for years, man, all right? For over 30, 40 plus years, you know, going into World War III, all right? And we told you, Israelites, you know, starting with you Native Americans, Latinos, and Negroes, that, hey, this day is coming. All right, and who is going to be with, you know, the Lord gave us the blueprint and told us how it's going to go down. All right, we don't know the ins and outs, but we know it's coming. All right,
I had a book for you. This is Revelation 19 and verse 10. And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, see thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant.
Right, he's talking to the angel. All right, the angel's telling him, don't bow down to me. You know, all right, I'm your brother, man. You know, hey, that's to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, not me, but you got that.
God, see thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahweh Shah.
Mm-hmm.
Worship the Most High, for the testimony of Yahweh Shah is the spirit of prophecy.
Right, the spirit of prophecy, all right? And that's what we're getting into, man, prophecy, all right? Things that are spoken before, all right? In which we're getting down to it. All right, and one of those prophecies that we mentioned through the Spirit is World War III. All right, yeah, that Matthew, oh, yeah, something up.
John, I
have. You can bring out that Matthew 24.
John, this is Matthew chapter 24, and starting at verse 4. And Yahweh Shah answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Hamashiach, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
Right, we shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. And lately, you know, even before the war with Russia and Ukraine, all right, we was hearing about that. And look what's taking place in that. You know, now we're seeing the Gaza Strip, you know, Israel attacking the Gaza Strip against those Palestinians. Mm-hmm. All right.
Strikes on Yemen,
that's another one. All right. And now, we're starting to see that these other countries, such as Iran, is starting to get involved now. Mm-hmm. All right, in which, hey, these are key players in this fight. All right, which were, and ultimately, hey, the scriptures talk about these same individuals, these same countries. All right, which they're not mentioning the same, you know, being called Russia or, you know, Iran. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not mentioning those names. They have scriptural names, you know, through spirit.
Can I read it?
You got it. You got it.
Just back in Ezekiel 38, it says, in the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, the Son of Man set thy face against Gog, the land of Magog.
Right, which is the land of Japheth, which, you know, Japheth was chased out of those lands, but ultimately, hey, through the Spirit, that's the land that it's talking about, which is Russia. All right? You got
it. It says, the chief priests of Meshach and Tubal and prophesied against him and said, thus saith the Lord of power.
Right. We're prophesying, Salakia. We're prophesying against Russia too, man. So we're not joining to Russia, man. All right? We're not with anybody. If we had to pick a side, it's always going to be through the Spirit, you know. Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah. Mm-hmm. All right? We're not with anybody, man. You know? But you got
it. It says, behold, I am against thee, O God, and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal. Verse 4, I will turn thee back and put hooks into thy jaws.
Mm-hmm.
And I will bring thee forth army, horses, and horsemen, mm-hmm. all of them clothed all sorts of armor,
mm-hmm.
even a great company with bucklers and shields. All of them handling swords. And this is the point that the brother was saying, that it's not their, you know, China.
Yeah.
So they go back to their original names.
Yeah.
So verse 5, it says Persia, Ethiopia, Libya, which technically those are all still names of present now. But
Well, you know, the Persians are, you know, Iran, you know, that's who he's talking about. You know, hey, man, these saints, the Lord is in brothers, he just read it, he's gearing them back up to prepare for war. All right? The Lord is putting hooks in Russia's jaw, which he's steering them back. All right? And to that, how you say in layman's term, warriors, man, fighters, man, you know?
And yeah, they're going back to that old USSR.
That's right. The water. It
says, Gomer and all his bands, the house of Togemar,
mm-hmm.
are the Lord's orders and all his bands and many people with you. And then I just have one more example.
You got it,
Psalm 83, and I'll just start at 6 to get, you know, the point of the names. It says, the tabernacle of Edom.
Mm-hmm. Who was the so-called white man?
And the Israelites.
Ishmael? Who was the Arabian, if I'm not mistaken?
Like, you know, you say, like, Afghanistan,
mm-hmm.
Iraq, mm-hmm. those are the Israelites.
That's right.
It says, of Moab.
Chinese.
And the Hagarenes.
Mm-hmm. You got it.
Gibal. Mm-hmm. And Ammon. And Amalek, the Philistines, with the inhabitants of Tyre, Assur,
mm-hmm.
also joined with them. They have hoping the children of Lot, Selah,
mm-hmm.
do unto them as unto the Ethiopianites, as to Sisera, as to Jaden, at the brook of Kishon. You know, that's
Yeah, it's just, you know, going into their biblical names, all right, and they're, you know, pretty much the locations, man, of where these people are inhabiting today.
Mm-hmm.
And really, man, they're going back to that warrior-like spirit, man. You know, I'm trying to go and grab a, what is that? Get your,
chair. Joel chapter 3, verse 9. It says, proclaim ye this among the Gentiles, prepare war. Wake up the mighty men, let all the men of war draw near, let mm-hmm. them come up.
Yeah, they're getting ready to go to war, man. All right, they're getting ready to fight. All right, the land of Jehoshaphat,
mm-hmm.
Yahweh Shaphat, which is Yahweh's judgment. All right, they're getting ready, all these nations are getting ready to go down to this land, which is, you know, in the Middle East, all right, near the Levant region, all right, ultimately to be judged, all right, for what these nations have done to the children of Israel, all right. Yes, I'm on that.
God, this is Joel chapter 3, verse 10. Beat your plowshares into swords,
mm-hmm.
your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong.
Right, man. They're no longer putting their resources towards agriculture, but now they're putting more resources in investing into their military,
mm-hmm.
into their artillery. Mm-hmm. All right, and that's what it's coming down to. These nations are getting ready to fight one another, man. All right.
Yeah, if I could say,
you got.
I mean, nobody really paid attention to, you know, South Korea like 10, 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Now they're making threats on South Korea. They're making threats towards the West.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody heard of, you know, these countries. You know, Pakistan, they have nuclear capability. So these weaker countries that United States thought they could trample on and set up embassies on, they're turning into wars. They're pretty much understanding that the West is the enemy.
Yep.
And they got Master P, okay, Vladimir Putin to back them up. You know, they got the big homie over there back east to back them up. Cause they know they can. They going back to that. I forgot to say real quick too. Going back to that Ezekiel 38, it talks about Gomer, which is Turkey. And yep. Turkey's still part of the NATO.
Mm-hmm.
So at some point in time, they're going to have to break ties with the NATO and take sides with Russia.
Yep. Ultimately, yeah. Because, hey, man, these nations are exchanging weaponry. because his brother was talking about mainly North Korea, they're exchanging weaponry with Russia. All right, there was an article that came out not too long ago where it was talking about how North Korea is exchanging selling guns to Russia. All right, hey man, things are getting tight. And what you think Russia is selling to North Korea? Nuclear capability, man. Mm-hmm. All right. The intercontinental ballistic missiles, man. All right. Which is coming down to it. All right.
Yeah, but and this is going to be, this precept I'm about to bring on is going to be concerning the time. All right. Because this is indeed the times that we're living in.
Mm-hmm.
So this is Exodus 15 and starting at verse 3. Matter of fact, I'm going to start at verse 2. The Lord is my strength and song, and he has become my salvation. He is my power, and I will prepare him an habitation. My father's power, and I will exalt him. Verse 3, what a point. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Now, his name is Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushai, that the whole world is called God and Jesus Christ. But the main point is this. The Lord is a man of war. And as you can see, concerning prophecy, which we opened up with, and actually what we're going into, these are indeed the times that we're living in. We're in a time of war, okay? And our power, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, is a man of war. So we want to see more and more articles, more and more things pop up on the news platform, concerning social media, TV, radio, wherever you are in this world, man. You're going to hear war, okay? World War III. It's on the brink, man. All right? And that's pretty much all I have, bro.
Yeah, man. Hey, another form of war is, hey, man, because we're going to start seeing over here in Babylon the Great, aka America, we're going to start seeing race wars. We're on a minute scale, level, but you start to see these between men and women and gender.
Yeah, gender wars.
You know, it's coming down to now, instead of it just being verbal, all right, it's going to be carnal, all right? Matter of fact, what is it, 2nd Ezra, chapter 15? Yeah, man, things are going to gear up, man. A lot of these individuals are going to be the same individuals that's going to be shipped off, or just have to, either way, you're going to fight over here or you're going to fight over there. It's going to come down to it, it's going to be serious, man.
Mm-hmm. I got it.
You got it.
I think this is the one you want. 2nd Ezra 15, starting with verse 14. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein.
Yeah, woe going into destruction. All right, hey, man, it's going to be gravely serious, man. All right. It's going to be a time never seen before, man. And people are going to meet your worst nightmare. But you got it.
2nd Ezra 15 and verse 15. For the sword and their destruction draw nigh.
Mm-hmm.
And one people shall stand up to fight against another, and swords in their hands.
Right, man. The swords going into killing instruments. You don't just have to be a literal sword for you simple jacks out there, for you simple individuals, man. It's gonna be guns and all type of killing instruments that you can get your hands on, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's gonna be like that movie Purge, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and individuals are gonna be fighting one another. All right, if things are gonna get real bad, man. All right, you can see in the movie The Purge, each and every one of them, man, individuals actually coming up and actually trying to put you to death, man. All right, hey, man, not even thinking about it, they just going through it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, this is the spirit and the vibration that is going out right now, man. You people are being conditioned to be killers, man. All right, and this is the vibration Esau is putting out. All right,
but keep going.
Second Ezra 15 and verse 16. For there shall be sedition among men,
mm-hmm.
and invading one another.
Mm-hmm.
They shall not regard the kings or princes.
Right, man. It's sedition among men, all right? Invading one another. People want to be breaking into each other's home. All right? Hey, man, they're not going to regard the mayors, the politicians, the governors, or the president. They're not going to listen to anything that these politicians have anything to say, man. They're going to start taking matters in their own hand because they don't believe that you people have their best, or these politicians have their best interest, which they don't. And we know that, and which we've been telling you Israelites and you people that, hey, we told y'all these people don't have your best interest, man. All right?
Well, we see it right now. It's mm-hmm. on the Texas border.
Yup. Okay?
Like, Tesla's like, man, what the government got going on?
Yeah.
You want to do this, that, and the third.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have a big list of states
who's backing up Texas right now and basically following pursuit.
Yep.
So this is going to be chaos. What, they dropping people off at the border,
yep.
People across the border. What? How do you feel, you know, a lot of Israelites or whoever coming across these borders don't know how to speak English or don't know what's going on. What, how do you think they're going to do? Or what do you think they're going to do on that day?
Yep.
Not knowing to speak in English, but they're going to get down and dirty. Well, things like that.
So like, they've already had reports of that happening.
Yeah.
You know, there was a TikTok video of Jake in New York basically saying people were going to your door to doors asking for change, and as soon as you try to get your wallet, it comes two men in the background and knock you inside the head and basically leave you for dead. Then they've also got, they had this one Jake, all right, Northern Kingdom Jake, he had the afro, woolly hair, whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
He was going around hitting old people with pipes. You know, this is what's really going on, man. You know, it's already happening. It's happening in New York. Hell, they're probably here in this godforsaken city where we live at. Because you see them every you see these Hamites.
Mm-hmm.
You know they're not from here. So you know we have a spiritual wind ability. This should go down.
Yep.
What they say, man? They had a big one showing them dropping off over there in Cascade, if I'm not mistaken.
The Cascade.
Yeah, they riding in taxi cab, dropping them off in the little Cascade, man.
Verse 16 says, "For there shall be sedition among men and invading one another.
Mm-hmm.
They shall not regard the kings, no princes in their courses of their actions shall stand in their power." I just wanted to say something on that. You know, that sedition vote, you know, can also go into like separation.
Oh, man.
So, you know, there should be a separation among men. And then also sedition goes into a civil overthrow. A civil overthrowing of authority.
Okay, I got it.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sedition is a noun in the online etymology, mid-14th century. It says rebellion, mm-hmm. uprising, revolt.
Yeah, like if you're rebellion, mm-hmm. you know, we always go in the word rebellion, it means like to declare war.
Yep.
When you're declaring war, that means you're picking a side, so you are separating yourself from, I guess you could say, whatever, general public or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And I read an article like, you're bad and you're too bad, and it showed how men, it's a study on men, how it was a certain age group from like 18 to like 45,
mm-hmm.
Men are starting to mentally leave this society.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So the sedition has already started.
Mm-hmm.
The more it starts mentally and spiritually first before it sets in the physical realm. You know what I'm saying? But go ahead, bro.
All right, continue on. It says, factitious commotion in the state. Concerns attempt to overthrow civil authority.
Factitious commotion. So commotion is stirring up a certain type of chaos or
confusion. Absolutely. Well,
you ever seen a riot? That's commotion.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You ever seen a mental concert?
Mm-hmm.
Or a single concert? That's commotion as well.
Mm-hmm.
Loud noises, people doing what they want. You know, it could come up with different things as in commotion, as in like people celebrating, but in this
state, it's going to be more so people causing
ruckus, being extremely violent. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, bro.
Just like if I may say,
we've seen an example of the leader might storm in the Capitol.
Yep, that was Trump. That was a commotion.
Yeah.
You know, that was a perfect example. Two people died after that. Two
yeah.
You know, you got it, bro.
Seeing on it says violent strife between factions.
Yep, violent strife between factions. So there goes that separation again.
Mm-hmm. There should be sedition among men between factions.
So there's two different fronts going after one another. So that's a separation. And it says violent strife. The scriptures tell us specifically to avoid strife,
mm-hmm.
you know, which strife is not fighting. You know what I'm saying? But go ahead, bro.
Continue on, it says civil or religious disorder.
Civil or religious disorder. Scripture tells us to do everything
decently in these people are going to go off their own carbon.
The scriptures also tell us in Proverbs to lean out on their own understanding. These people are
going
to
lean on their own understanding.
They're going to say
it says civil or religious disorder.
yet they're going to go off of their own order and be disorderly
because they're tired of the orders
that they've been given from the government. They're going to disregard Romans 13 and 1 and do what the fuck they want to do, which is going to cause what we've been hearing that phrase
a lot lately, civil war. Go ahead.
It says riot,
rebelliousness.
Keep going.
Continuing on, it says civil disorder.
There goes that word civil.
Civil disorder. So there will be a civil war.
That's just going to be one. A civil war is just
one domino. It's a domino effect. Don't think civil war. I want you civil war. No, but it's going to be civil war.
Mm-hmm.
Apparitions.
Yep.
We created peace.
Mm-hmm.
Leviathan coming out. MOTV. World War III. Missiles. Chariots. The men of the Lord going crazy. Spiritual power, healings. Civil war is just one domino. Go ahead, bro.
It says civil disorder, dissension, strife, rebellion, mutiny. Literally a going apart.
And the last one is separation.
There you go.
Finally said it. So let's reread it with the word separation. I'm going to read it for you.
You got it. So this is 2 Ezra chapter 15 and 16.
For there shall be separation
among men,
invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand for their power.
Because that's so heavy, man, and deep, because you can actually see. Hey, these people, and we're getting examples, but it's going to be on a higher scale how these people are going to be very rebellious against one another, man, against these politicians, government. We're starting to see it, man. Even these states are slowly dividing from one another, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's getting so bad to the point where we're going to start seeing states divide from each other. Hey, man. Hey, people are not going to be able to enter in other states, man. They're not going to be able to enter in certain cities, man.
Let's keep reading.
Yeah, yeah, you got it.
So verse 17, it says, man shall desire to go into a city,
yep,
and shall not be able.
That's right, man. Not be able, man. Hey, not just going to be, because we understand the MOTB is another main prophecy that we're waiting on, which is coming, and it's being mentioned.
It's here.
And a lot of individuals just not being made mandatory yet. But another reason why some individuals might not be able to enter in certain cities is because, hey, man, the division with these countries, these states, all right, these cities, all right, some are not going to agree. That's why certain Jakes, you think that you're going to be able to, especially here in Atlanta, a lot of Jakes think they're going to be able to exit and go to these small country towns. But the Edomites in these small country towns don't want you Jakes there. So then you're not going to be able to enter in some of these small country towns. Really, a lot of Jakes don't know some of the history, but a lot of them, these Edomites don't like you Jakes, man. They got restaurants and they got examples of them lynching Jake. They got pictures of them in Sundown Town. All right? We seen examples through, Oprah? All right? It was a video a long time ago with Oprah talking about Hall County and Forsyth County. All right? You Jakes wouldn't survive up there, man, going past there, Forsyth and Hall County. You think that you're going to make it past there, then them Edomites are not going to have it, all right? And there's other countries that are, not countries, but other cities that you Jakes think you're going to make it to and you're not, all right? And it's just going to come down to you fighting these individuals, or, hey, some of these might just come down to hunt you, all right? Because because what's going on between Trump and the presidency, all right, and these Edomites are being very rebellious, man, all right, against these other Edomites, man. We're starting to see the division in Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, man, all right?
A lot of chaos.
We saw an example back in, 2019, 2020,
mm-hmm.
The pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, once it hit America, you know, the cops was posted, damn that, each exit. All right, if you was over there in China, you couldn't come to America.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you was American, you had to stay over there, man. And then too, you got to think about like the brother said, newly creatures, Leviathans. They're gonna stop you from going to one city to the next. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be chaotic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just back up one up.
All right, I was just thinking about scripture. Anybody got something?
We still in that,
You can continue on that.
Yeah, I'll start from 16 again. 2 Corinthians 15:16, for there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another, they shall not regard the kings and princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power.
Right, they're going to take matters in their own hand. Alright, they're going to take matters in their own hand. They're going to think that, hey, they should set up. Alright, hey, these might already thinking that they can overthrow the government and set up their own, you know, government, which is not going to happen. Alright, hey, once this place, really, a matter of fact, I have the scripture. This is, I'm going to read it real quick. This is Matthew 12:26. It says, and if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand? Right, man. Hey, man, once this country is already divided, we are moving to separation, man. All right? We're already seeing the separation. It's being divided. All right? And because it's being divided, this place is no longer standing, man. It's easy for the taking. All right? Which is all prophecies, all set up to happen. All right?
Yeah, it's not a coincidence that they're coming out with this Civil War movie in April.
Yeah.
You know, Esau is using this predictive program to show you what's going on. Mm-hmm. Just like all these Purge movies. People go see the Purge movies.
Mm-hmm.
They be laughing and chuckling. We be sitting there, yeah, that's that scripture, brother, you know, going in. Mm-hmm. But, hey, these people going to find out the hard way, man. And then, like, in the movie The Purge, what is Jake doing? Partying,
mm-hmm.
bullshitting.
Yeah, they had a party bus.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was one scene, they had a whole party bus. It was going to block to block.
The whole street was blocked off for the party.
Yeah, man, that shit was awful. Niggas were getting drunk, doing coke. Niggas were just bashing niggas upside the head just for the fucking fun of it. And then Esau came through with that fucking 18-wheeler.
Yeah.
Started lighting shit up.
Started lighting shit up, man.
So a lot of you Jays, y'all think it's a game, man. Hey, peace and safety.
Mm-hmm. Y'all think y'all gonna be comfortable, man, but you really not gonna be comfortable. Things are gonna get worse. Alright. As soon as we're going according to Jeremiah 30, Jacob's trouble. Alright. But
you can continue on with that.
Second Andrew. Oh, sure.
Alright, 2 Corinthians 15:17. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able.
Right.
Yeah, I was gonna say, and then they're already, how do I say this? They're coming out with that X, this new pandemic, this new boogeyman scaring pants out of these people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they say it's more lethal than what happened in 2020. So you can add that to the list of plagues that's happening as well. And then what happened with the last boogeyman that they brought about, you saw it. People from New York couldn't go to Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
People that was from Florida, Georgia said, oh, hell no, y'all gotta go back to Florida, man.
Mm-hmm.
So this stuff, Esau does the same old alley-oop with this stuff, man. So, you know, you can only imagine these borders getting shut down, but you gotta have that MOTB
mm-hmm.
to, you know, eventually move around. You know, those days.
That's right, man.
You're right, yeah, you're gonna have to.
You wanna say something?
Yeah, you're gonna have to have
that MOTB to move around, man. Alright? Just to do anything, you know?
Either you eat, you know, buy, sell.
You know, it's coming down to it, man. Alright, you people won't be able to maneuver without these devices.
It's supposed to
keep you all comfortable, but hey, your place, you're not gonna be comfortable here, man. Alright? It's only gonna get worse, alright? And hey, man, you people think that we're, you know, fear-mongers, but hey, man, ultimately, man, technically we are, man. Because we're supposed to install the fear of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai in you, man.
Yeah.
All right, which, going to Proverbs chapter 1, it tells you, getting the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding is the fear of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Because, hey, man, we wouldn't be able to understand these things without fearing the Lord, man. Mm-hmm. All right?
Yeah, they have persuaded.
Yeah, right.
All the apostles and those that don't start all of them down.
Right, we're supposed to persuade men.
That's right.
Yeah, it's on up.
Hold on, I was just following along in that 2 Corinthians 15. I still got that Matthew.
You go ahead, Matthew.
No, I'm sure. Come on.
This is Matthew.
Going back to Matthew chapter 24. And verse 6 again. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass.
Right, it has to happen. So if you don't understand why it's happening, It's because it has to happen in order for us to get out of here, man.
Yep.
All right? In order for Jacob to be set up in the heavenly kingdom on earth, man. All right? It's going to be set up, all right, starting with Yahweh Shah. All right? So, you got to
come. But the end is not yet.
Mm-hmm. We're not at the end yet. Just because these things are happening, all right, doesn't mean we're at the end yet, man. Famine, pestilence, earthquakes, rumors of wars, just because these things are taking place, they don't mean that we're at the end yet. You know, hey, we won't see it until those missiles are shot off, man.
Yep. For nation shall rise against nation.
Mm-hmm.
Which is clear as day. Civil war, man.
Yeah.
All right, prime example. That one Jake in the courtroom. He was fed up with that Edomite bitch.
Yeah.
He ran and leaped and basically attacked the bitch.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah,
that's a prime example.
Jake fed up, man. We fed up, man. You gotta be tired of this place at this point, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah. Come on, man. Like, at this point, it's just like, what do we have here? You really don't have anything. But the Lord here, he's giving us a way. He's offering us so much, man. Mm-hmm. All we gotta do is, hey, do his will, do his work. Yeah. All right?
If I can land, yeah. That's why, after I say this, back up with one more verse.
Got it.
Yeah, I'm getting a little bit more meat off the bone. But that's why I just land back off the brother who said he offered so much more. That's why you have to get over yourself.
Yeah.
Whatever you got going in your life. Fuck a job. This is just like redundant stuff to go be saying. You know? Mm-hmm. That's the point that I'm tired of saying.
Yeah.
Like, to get a job, you know, you got a family. Care for them to an extent, bro. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Don't be no fucking family man and shit mm-hmm. like that. You know, it's not that you got to be able to take care of them, but you got to have a job where you have responsibility to the spirit that must be done, that these other people are depending on you. You know, some things have to be forsaken to accomplish the mission that the Lord put on you. You know, you gave you a mission,
it's a task.
Got it in one task and get over yourself and understand the reason of the service. What you're doing, the Lord's not asking us to do a lot.
Mm-hmm.
When you think about it, He's not asking us to do a lot. He's doing it.
It's reasonable.
It's very reasonable.
And then He's not asking us to
do a lot, but we're asking Him to do a lot.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Take this whole fucking system.
Yeah.
You know, destroy the miracle, send 200 million missiles. He's asking you to read the book.
You got to see
how reasonable that is. If you can't get over yourself in whatever fucking situation you're going through, you are not deserving to receive these certain perks and ultimately be delivered from what's to come. You know? I did a PSA video last night and said in there, if you don't want to work, the Lord will not work with you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's on you.
Mm-hmm.
You know? That is on you. So go back up one verse where it says, trouble. You got to
turn it over. All right, because it was glad back
on what you were saying. This is John 12 and verse 25. It said, he that loves his life shall lose it.
Mm-hmm.
And he that hath his life in this world shall keep it until life eternal. If any man this is John chapter 12 and verse 25. He that love his life shall lose
what? Why is it saying?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, you know, let me say this. Sometimes the question why is a good one, especially when it's used as a very childish or churlish thing, okay? Like a little kid, you'd be like, no, you can't do that. Why? Because this. Why? Because that. Why? You see what I'm saying? But sometimes you do have to inquire why.
Why is the Lord saying,
if you love your life?
So reread.
This is John 12, verse 25.
He that loveth his life shall lose it.
Right. The reason he's saying is, if you love your life, that means you think you have control of it.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't understand that the Lord has created an illusion of control, or he's created an illusion of choice, because really,
yeah.
Really,
So why are you so attached to it? Right. Understand that you are a vessel that is being used.
Okay.
By the master. Okay? Read from the top and you're going to keep going.
God, this is John
12 and verse 25.
That's why you're going to lose it. Because you think you're in control. You're fucking not. And when you lose it, that's the Lord telling you, you're not in control. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, bro.
Well, I'm about to say something. We all said it, and I'm going to say it like this. There's times where we have a conversation.
One thing we always say is,
I never knew I was going to be here. Yeah. I never knew this was going to happen. I never knew that was going to happen. I didn't know I was going to, you know, come out here and do this, that, and the third. So that just lets you know already, we're not in control in the first place, okay? Just that point up.
Because going off what you're saying, man, we understand, too, when we come in this thing, we can lose our life at any time. This is up to you, how about shooting outside?
Matter of fact, now that you said that, so when you get the book of James, speaking about your paper,
it says, he that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it until life eternal.
Right. So he that hated his life. Mm-hmm. So let's get this understood too. Okay? It's not sitting here saying, hate your fucking self. Right. Because because you're always trying to push the law statutes and commandments. Mm-hmm. If you're pushing the law statutes and commandments, you have to care for yourself.
Right.
It's called self-care. Because if you're keeping the law statutes and commandments, you're correct.
You're being brotherly. You're doing the right things. You're studying. You're praying to the Lord. You're showing
a high level of respect towards your comrades, things of that nature. You're better than yourself in your life. But there's an extent that you go to, and that's what you call being either under or over righteous.
Yeah.
Okay? Simple. So, was there more though?
Yeah. Verse 26, it says, if any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be.
There you go. If my sheep follow my voice, just prepare to go in.
If any man serve me, him will my father honor.
There you go. So now,
yeah,
it's your life. It's to an extent where you take things. Mm-hmm. Okay?
That means you done got over yourself.
Whatever the fuck you got going on, doesn't really matter to you. You're just doing it to get power in society. But ultimately, you keep it some pocket change so you can put gas in your car when you can.
Mm-hmm.
You put gas in your car to go fellowship. You put gas in your car. A random example, okay, and you understand that maybe the job you had is funding what you need to do in the spirit, okay, simple, so therefore you follow the other side, and then end up getting these perks that are spoken about in the Bible, salvation, mm-hmm. spiritual power, and things of that nature, because you hated your life, mm-hmm. that's in the sense of, you got over yourself, and you didn't let anything get in the way of the truth.
A lot of people fall by
the wayside because they let things of this society, of this world, get in the way because they're looking out there and like to fucking them.
Yeah, not the world.
Or the things in it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Including your damn self. Alright? We have to function around in this world. I always tell bros, we have to master the carnal and the spiritual. We're here. When you read about the house shine, that's what he did. He mastered it all. That's why he was perfect. He mastered the spiritual, mastered the carnal side. Okay? He did. He was the ultimate man. Alright, was it more? Okay, go back to that Matthew 24 a little bit. Also, like you didn't get that James. Because this brother said what? This brother said, you don't know when he's gonna get turned off, or if the Lord will keep it on, keep watching.
Yeah.
And he's about it.
Yeah.
You know? Because this is all for his amusement.
Yeah.
Alright, so you got it, bro.
Alright, this is James chapter 4, starting verse 13. Go to now, ye that say today or tomorrow, we will go into such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and get gain. Verse 14, whereas you know, not what shall be on the morrow, for what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little time and then vanishes away.
It's fading away. You ever make some tea, a little tea kettle, it makes the whistle, you see the little vapors coming up, they only go to a certain extent before they disappear. That is your life.
Yeah.
That's your life. Okay?
So that's why I said in the
beginning of the verse that he read,
that officer read,
go to now.
That's why Paul said what?
Be careful for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Being careful for nothing is equivalent
to what Howard Schott was saying with he paid his life so pretty much the
pain. Okay? Because when we go into that word careful, it means
not having any anxiety or worry.
All right?
Motherfuckers be out here worried.
Fuck that bill, bro.
Bring your dumb
ass to camp.
Yeah, my girl this, my girl that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, fuck that girl. Bring your dumb ass to camp.
Yeah.
And I'm saying it like that on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Bring your little simple ass to camp. Stop fucking lying on.
You know? Press that record button.
Get your little simple ass finger and press that simple ass record button.
And say some simple words.
Be with the
scriptures. And then press the record button.
How fucking hard is that? How hard is that?
You do that consistently, elevating here and there, you get on the chariot.
Yeah, it's just glorifying our power. You know?
How easy is that?
The motherfuckers out here think that shit hard.
You really think that shit hard?
That shit wild, man.
You know, because you had to slide here.
Because you know Jake, man. Jake's so simple, man. When
they hear a script like,
their life is like a vapor of smoke. They go into this.
Oh, I need to be a nigga, man.
I live your life only once, YOLO. You know, but hey, the scripture talks about how you really should be conducting your life, man. What you really should be doing. And that's what we're getting into. We're trying to tell you, Jake, don't be a rebellious nigga, man. Hey, hearken unto y'all by shooting y'all shot. Repent.
The whole movie of man.
Oh, that's right. You got it.
Like it says in the previous year, exactly.
He's the Lord gave the blueprint to put you in the ballpark to be successful.
Yes.
Okay?
Simple.
But it's just like the same thing. Sometimes,
I'll say this, and brothers, y'all can call me out live on camera and say, nah, God, you lying on motherfucker.
But anytime I set up a test or anything like that, I will tell brothers,
hey, this is what I'm calling. Hey, I'm making a study guide or something like that. Or hey, I'm going to quiz y'all tomorrow. Make sure you study this, that, and the third, because this is what we're going to be on. Because I'm setting you up for success.
Why the fuck would I want you to fail?
Right. Like I said, you're not wrong.
Why would I want you to fail? So it's the same thing with the Lord is doing to us when he
gives us his good book.
The Bible, collection of books. Okay? He's giving us the blueprint on how to succeed,
to get onto the chariot, then we'll learn the rest in the kingdom.
But right now, he's telling us to focus on how to get on the chariot.
He's giving us the
blueprint of what to do, how to do it, when to do it. And then that's reasonable enough for him to be acceptable in his sight.
Okay, so let's go back to Matthew 24 and lead up to where it says,
the trouble.
Yes.
Okay. This is on Matthew 24, starting at verse 6 again. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
Mm-hmm.
See that ye be not troubled.
Stop right there. And all of this that I was saying was for that word trouble.
All of what I just said right now, to bring it back full circle, is for that word trouble.
When you go into that word trouble, it means to not panic. Do not panic.
When you hear the rumors of wars, all these things that are going around,
all these motherfuckers,
you know why they're getting panicked down here?
Because they love their life.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
They love their life and they're not careful for nothing. Okay? That's why they're going to be troubled. That's why they're going to fucking panic. But if us disregard a lot of shit in this life and drop our nets just like the disciples did and follow after Yahweh Shai, we will not panic. What was you going to say, man?
I was going to just back you up. And the Lord, you know, once you come into this thing, you know, he molds your life
to the point where
he will take some things
yeah.
and
him taking things and you realize, oh, I'm still here, I can still do this.
Yes.
You just enjoying your life, you know. Twitch says walk your walk honestly.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So once you do certain things and basically level up in the spirit and start getting used to certain things, understanding that, hey, there's a balance. Even Job,
yeah.
You know, he had to tell his real, like why would I curse the Most High and die? Like, right. It's, yeah.
What do we always say? The prophecies are like contractions.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So there's certain contractions that are going to happen in your personal walk, like the brother was just saying. If the Lord may take certain things, he's not going to do it all at once. It's going to be increments.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to make certain contractions in your life to build your faith.
You see what I'm saying? Been in it for 3 years.
There's certain things in those 3 years that you get into the book of Ecclesiasticus, wisdom shall take you down a crooked path. It's going to build them contractions to build you stronger.
So you can understand,
this is why you're following me. If every time he sends you a contraction, you find he gives you a way to escape. That's the scripture.
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
I think it's in Corinthians where it talks about he doesn't put as much on you as, you know, he puts on you what you can.
Is it light affliction and so on?
1 Corinthians 10:13.
Please get it. I think that's exactly it. You know, but he gives you a way to escape.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
This is 1 Corinthians 10:13. There have no temptation taken.
That's it. So like it, brother. Like, because also too, because you know, some wacky type of Christians who bring this out, or some people who kind of believe in the Bible bring this out and show you how the Bible contradicts itself.
Mm-hmm.
Because the scriptures do say what? That the Lord does not tempt.
Yeah.
But then he is just worth taking. But if you go into the word temptation, you just need to test. Not tempting.
Alright? There's a big difference between a
test and a tempt. Okay?
Alright? A tempt is almost like
an aggravation to do something.
Mm-hmm.
Go read about when Satan went to Yahweh Shai. That was tempting.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't Yahweh who went to Yahweh Shai. It was Satan. Okay? Keep going, bro.
1 Corinthians 10:13. There have no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man.
Right, but such as is common to man. So let's replace that word temptation with test. Say it with test.
1 Corinthians 10:13. There have no test taken you, but such as is common to man.
That's a contraction. Mm-hmm. So when you're going through your tests and trials and tribulations, you're going through a little contraction. That's it. It's painful. That's what the scriptures say. It's loosely paraphrasing that too. When you're going through it, it feels bad. But the outcome is good.
Continue on and says, but the Most High is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape that ye may be able to bear it.
Man, it says the Lord is faithful.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord is faithful. So why can't you be faithful to the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to do anything
else that anybody, Joe Schmo, nigga up the block is going through.
Right.
Nigga up the block going through. Nigga up the block might be going through more shit than you.
Right. It says right here. In the NLT it says, this is 1 Corinthians 10:13. Let's read it right quick. The temptations in your life are no different from what others experience. That's like what they're saying.
Nigga up the block. You're going through exactly what you're going through a fucking more, man.
And you over here holding like a taco, cracking like a fucking egg, and you got the name of the Lord.
Shoot.
Bro, what's wrong with you, man? What's wrong with you?
Yeah, baby.
But keep reading that. You said that faith. It said the Lord is faithful to them.
Yeah, God.
Keep reading that. The Lord is faithful to them, bro. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
If the Lord got more faith in you than you do him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, ultimately he put it in you, okay? But you gotta trust the circumstances that you're going through is based off the measure of faith that he gave you. Even if you have to face death,
mm-hmm.
the Lord gave you enough faith to experience death.
Real talk. You gotta think of it that way.
Even if you pass on, you know,
go back to the spirit world.
Sometimes you can't look at it as like, oh, he got judged. Huh? his faith was that high that the Lord found it acceptable for him to deal with that. Because we understand what the book of Thessalonians says in the fourth chapter. We're going to come back. We're going to see the brother when he passed. We're going to see him again. But we're definitely going to come back. And we're going to see him. You know, but they had so, they had the measure of faith that was given to him. You might not even know the potential of faith that was given to you, but that measure of faith that was given was acceptable for him to experience that. That's a high, that's a, when a brother passes on in faith, that lets me know he had a high level of faith. Because not every brother can experience it. You know? Was that, that's pretty much it, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
You got something for
you? This is Hebrews 12 and verse 6. And it says, for whom the Lord lovingly chastened, which we're going to chasten and, misfortune, which, you know, and we deal with a lot of misfortune in this church, you know what I'm saying? But it says, for the whom the Lord loved. So the Lord, hey, this is love, man. Regardless, man, of what we, even down to getting rebuked, man. Jake get butthurt, but really can't be butthurt about getting rebuked, man. Like, it's love at the end of the day. I feel some type of way if a brother didn't rebuke me if I'm going off on something. Because he wouldn't show that he actually loved or cared for me, man. You know what I'm saying? So the continue on and says, it scorched every son when he received it. If he endured chastening, the Most High dealing with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the Father chastened not?
Yeah, it says if you endure it. Yeah. So if you're enduring it, that means you are showing faith.
Right.
You're showing faith in the Lord can work it.
Yeah.
Because you are giving him. Okay? So endure that. So these times, that's why it says, be not troubled. Don't panic. Okay? Don't panic. That's why it says, he that loveth his life will lose it. Because you're going to start fucking panicking. Because you worry about everything you got going on in America. You know, Jake Logan said, fuck them kids. You know what I'm saying? But to an extent, you get what I'm saying? Like, real talk, don't worry about the kids like that. But if you show endurance to the Lord got your kids because he's faithful and true. You see what I'm saying?
Hey, Yahweh, we wouldn't be here if it was for Yahweh. So he's the one that created you. So he has control over your family. You just gotta worship and serve him and the Heavenly Father, man. You know?
That's it.
You can't be worried about, you know, like it says, people worship the creature more than the creator. You can't worship, you know, this temporal setup or, you know, your family or whatnot over the Lord. The Lord created us.
Right. You be looking like that, you might be in the car praying to Donald Trump.
Yeah, that shit
was off. Fuck, no, that shit was not off. Yes, pray to that nigga, you fucking cracker. Yes, that is your God. All right?
Yeah,
this shit was not off. You pray to Donald Trump, nigga. Go cast that fucking ballot. And understand that Donald Trump just lost a fucking case of defamation. He has to pay $80 million to a motherfucker right now. Okay? Go pray to you. The Trump can't even pray to his damn self to pay, you know. He's not. He has to pay $83 million. Okay? That's what you're praying to. Go ahead and pray to it. But for Jake out there, that's how it's going to fucking happen. That's why in Howard Shai 7 he said, you are the father of the devil. Because you fucking pray to him too.
Yeah.
That's my president. You so fucking. It's your God too, bitch.
Yeah.
Go learn Biden and have him help. Matter of fact, give him on. What's that? You know, 32, started like 35, something like that. You know, because they want to spread these powers, the Lord told me to go do it. Go fucking do it. And then once you do it, let me go where they at. Tell them to pull up on them. You know?
You said, yeah.
You got it?
This is Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 35. It says, to me belong with vengeance and recompense. Their foot shall slide in due time.
Whose foot? These niggas' foot shall slide in due time. Okay? Because when you read this, what's written?
It's worth not reading.
And when you get further into it, you understand who he's talking to. He's not talking to the Stephen. He's talking to Jake. All right? your foot shall slide in your tongue. What lingo does that sound like?
That's what Jay said today.
Catch him slipping.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Catch him slipping. Well, I'm slide. Yeah.
I'm sliding.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, catch that slipping.
Y'all trying to slide?
Exactly. See what I'm saying?
That's true.
There's slang in the scripts, bro. Yeah. Real talk. There's slang in the scripts.
Yeah.
You know, when Paul, I'm getting a little off topic, when Paul talked about, I count it all as dumb. He's like, man, all this shit, boom,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
That's that slang. That's how Paul was talking, real talk.
Yeah.
That's all this is bullshit. Because he was careful for nothing, which he said in the same chapter. Okay?
I think that's why he said, God and ruin speech.
Oh, that's in Corinthians.
Yeah.
No, I mean, he ruined speech, mm-hmm. but yet not in knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Because when he's talking about ruined speech, is vulgar language, which we always go into, the word vulgar just means common language.
Common
language.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I say, man. I say, hey, you know, in that bitch. You know what I'm talking about. This is common language. You know, there's better word for us. Like, look at that woman over yonder.
Yeah.
So who the fuck are you talking about? <today? laughs> You know what I'm saying? You know, brothers in this camp, I'm pulling legs and slapping these.
Yeah. Funny, bro.
Common language.
Right.
You know, continue.
Kind of. Their foot shall slide in due time, for the day of their calamity is at hand.
Yep. And the foot shall slide in due time, the day of the calamity is at hand, and that's perfectly what the brother was opening up with.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Marshall Lawton, we were going into the sedition. We brought up the second edge.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's the calamity in due time, man.
It says, and the things that shall come upon them make haste.
And the things that come upon them shall make haste. These are the prophecies that we're speaking right now. These things are going to come real quick.
Mm-hmm. Come on. It says, for Yahweh shall judge his people.
There we go. So now it's specifically talking, it's telling you who's specifically talking to and about.
Yeah, right.
And Yahweh shall judge his people. You can figure out who his people is when you read the book of Exodus.
You can figure out who his people is by reading Sirach 24. You can figure out who his people is reading Deuteronomy 28.
You know, you can figure out who his people are with a plethora of scripts.
The
book of Jeremiah. Yeah, that's a good guy. Plain example who Israel is.
Ezekiel. It talks about how stubborn.
Ezekiel 37 chapter.
It talks about
the new covenant. You know, just like you said, Jeremiah, 31.
Because you're going to just be
Book of the Rule. I was thinking Book of the Rule.
I didn't even say it. I was leaving it for you.
Yeah.
But I was thinking Book of the Rule. You know what I'm saying? But we got the implication of who the Lord is speaking to in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
So he says, what are you going to do?
All right. It says, verse 36, it says, for Yahweh shall judge his people,
yep.
and repent himself for his servants.
That's why we're sitting here talking right now. It is reasonable for you to get that simple-ass finger, press that simple-ass record button, do a simple lesson, press that simple record button again, and simply post it to the page. Because you doing that consistently, and plus, I'm just talking about one aspect of the truth, and plus everything else consistently and getting better at it over time, the Lord will repent himself for you.
So reread
that one more time, the Lord said the Lord will repent himself for you.
It said, verse 36 is, for Yahweh shall judge his people and repent himself for his servants.
Yes. Where's the word repent?
Bro, off the top of the dome, bro.
Where's the word repent?
Thank
you. So it's saying the Lord will turn back from his servants.
He's going to judge his people,
but you've been doing the work. You've been praying to me. You know,
you've been loving me. You've been showing a lot of charity.
And charity covers the multitude of sins. You know, you've been prophesying all these little aspects of the truth that the body carries. I'm looking at y'all. I'm looking at your ignorance. when I judge these people, it's all like what will happen to y'all. Y'all gonna see it happen around you, but not to you, because I repented myself from y'all. I turned back, you know, I went back from judging you like how I'm gonna judge these people. That's what Deuteronomy 32 is saying right now. Because what? You did the work, and you put the war first, and you hated your life. Everything come back full circle.
We're saying right now. Yeah. Exactly. The scripture saying Hebrews does lay one to that rest.
Perfect script, bro. Let us labor into that rest. And what else? What same chapter, same book, right? It says what? That you shall not forget your labor or whatever it does.
Right.
So now he can repent himself from you. You know? You just read in, what is that, John 12? That what? You follow after Yahweh Shai, he can speak good to you, to the Lord.
Yep.
He can, thank you, man. You know, Yahweh Shai, when he sees his doing work, being good, like it says in the book of Titus, to be good, even though it's speaking about the aged woman, that's us too.
Yeah.
You know, to be good. He's like, thank you, man. Shit. Because all these niggas acting like damn monkey, wild grapes.
Yep.
Acting crazy, you being good, finally, I can like say something to the Lord.
Yeah.
And when he presents the crowns, good job, my good and
faithful. What's that? Second chapter.
What's that? Well, it says, he saw a man with a high stature.
Yeah, second chapter.
You said second Ezra 2?
Yeah. I know it was earlier.
You didn't watch that,
guy. Yeah, you got it, bro. No, because, oh, you got it, you found
it? Tom, what verse is that?
Go to, you can start at verse 42, bro.
Tom, this is 2 Ezra 2, Florida, brother. And verse
47. And it reads, so he answered and said unto you, it is the Son of the Most High.
Matter of fact, now go up.
Yeah,
so it's at 42. Yeah, slightly. This is 2 Ezra 2 and 42. I, Ezra, saw upon Mount Sinai a great people, whom I could not number. And they all praised the Lord with songs. And in the midst of them, there was a young man of high stature, taller than all the rest, which is Yahweh Shai, okay? Then it says, and upon every one of their heads he set crowns, and was more exalted, which I marvel at greatly. Verse 44. So I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? Verse 45. And he answered and said unto me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing, okay, and put on emerald, and have confessed the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Now we put off the way of the world, man.
Yep.
We started to separate, through the Spirit, man. We're starting to separate ourselves. All we have, you know, being you know, around in the truth, we separate ourselves from the way of the world. That's what the elect is doing. They're separating themselves from the way of the world, getting away from these pagan idols. You know, there's certain things that we understand that, hey, man, it's coming into fruition, man. And this is the things that, hey, the Lord is telling us who these individuals and what they're going to be doing on this side that made it on that chariot. That's what that's telling us, man. And what we ought to be doing, we should be doing those things because we should be, what the scriptures say, working our own salvation with fear and trembling.
Yeah.
All right? This is a part of it, man. We're working out our own salvation with fear and trembling.
There's something I had to say that let me reread verse 45, 2 Ezra 2 and 45. He answered me, he answered and said unto me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing and put on the mortal, immortal.
Put off the mortal, like you said, immediately,
right? Yeah, that's right. And have confessed the name of the Most High, which a lot of people don't do. And a lot of people reject the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Okay? Continue on knowing in verse 45, and it says, now are they crowned and receive songs.
It's reasonable to get off the mortality
than wanting to put it. When you get this truth and actually strive for it, you're putting on immortality
every single day.
Yeah.
Okay? You're putting it on every single day.
All right?
Therefore, you're striving after the masteries and you're striving after. And we can say striving to fight.
Yeah, it's about
it. We're fighting to get closer to your Yahweh Shai, which is fighting closer to get to immortality. And then you get your reasonable reward, which is going into.
Yeah. Then it says, verse 46, then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowneth them and give of them songs in their hands? So he answered,
you see that though?
He said, what young person?
What young person? You know what's speaking about
Yahweh Shai, but it's showing how he was renewed when he came back. And what the scriptures tell us, renew yourself, renew your mind. Mm-hmm. What did he talk to Nicodemus about?
You know, that guy's a baby.
Renewing, reborn. Yeah. So he says, who is this young man? A renewed Yahweh Shai who came to meet the earth not as a man.
That's right.
You see that? That's heavy, that's deep.
Yeah.
You know, you got it, bro.
God, continuing on, verse 47. So he answered, he said unto me, it is the Son of the Most High. Matter of fact, slightly. So he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of the Most High, whom they have confessed in the world. Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Verse 48, last one. Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell my people what manner of things, how great wonders of the Lord thy power thou hast seen.
Yep. Mm-hmm. You see? And the angel saying that, just a synopsis, you go to the testimony.
That's what it was. You know what I'm saying? So now we have the testimony. So drop your net straight away and go follow after your house, man.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And get your reasonable reward for it. Okay? So go back to Deuteronomy real quick. 32.
Alright.
What was that? Like
36 or 37?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse. I'm going to continue on, I'm going to read 36 again because there's a little bit more. It says, for Yahweh shall judge his people and repent himself for his servant when he seeth that their power is gone and there is none shut up or left. And he shall say,
you see that? When his power is gone and there's none shut up or left. Okay? Which means what?
That praying to Jesus shit. You know, praying to Yahweh yogurt, you know who I'm talking to.
Mm-hmm.
Praying to Christ, you know, or shit. A lot of congregations worshiping their leader.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Second command.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, second under the church.
That makes me want to.
That's so best.
Ah, sinful nation.
Yeah.
You know, like, fuck, bro. You know, that's what he's talking about. Go ahead. All right. Continuing on.
He said, and he shall say, where are their gods, their rock in whom they trust?
Yeah, like that Edomite praying to Donald Trump. Where is he? I told you where he is. He's in court, losing like a motherfucker. He owed $83 million to the motherfucker right now. That's where he's at. That's where he's at, motherfucker. Okay, reread that.
This is Deuteronomy 32 and verse 37. And it says, he shall say, where are their gods, their rock in whom they trusted?
Mm-hmm.
Where they at? Where they at?
So when the Civil War pops, like MOTV comes. When the whole world gets tried and the temptation comes, like it says in Revelation, the third chapter. Where they at, though?
Mm-hmm. Where they at? Where's Jesus at? Where's Donald Trump at? Where's Biden at?
Mm-hmm.
You know, go ahead, bro.
Come, this is Judges 10, and starting around verse 13. Yet ye have forsaken me and served other gods.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore I will deliver you no more. verse 14.
Yeah, the Lord ain't, you got it, go ahead.
No, Bible side, you got it.
All right. Yeah, man, the Lord ain't saving you niggas, man. You two, hey, 2/3 of Israel is going to already be cut off, man. Because he already know how most of you, or majority of you, what you going to do, man.
Yep.
You know? You got
God. Verse 14. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen. Mm-hmm. It was a choice. Yep. Okay? You're going to serve me, or you're going to serve all these other pagan gods. You're going to serve the Jesus Christ's. You're going to serve your Muhammad's, your Buddha's, your Ahayah's, your Yeshua's, Jehovah's, okay? Any other name, man. Those are all false names, man. Excuse me. All right, the true name is Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man.
All right, okay. If I may say, because you already have these Christians already believe they chose the Lord. You know what I'm saying? But we understand through the scriptures, hey, the Lord, we didn't choose the Lord. The Lord chose us.
Humble and yep.
Hey, that's why, going back to what you were saying earlier in the stream, hey, man, we didn't know we was going to be in this position, man. Who ever thought that we would be out? Bro, I never thought. I'm just speaking to myself, and I'm pretty sure brothers can relate. Bro, I never thought that I'd be out prophesying and teaching the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. No man thought of that, man. All right? Yeah, you know.
Yes, you, hey, you're on point, man. Okay. Because they love Yahweh so much, they can't fathom the fact that Jesus Christ is the incorrect name.
Right.
You know, they love coming to come to the temples or the church houses, saying I can come who I am as I am, because they love homosexual. Excuse me, slightly. They love the life of being a sodomite. This, that, and the third. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, slightly like that. But continuing on, Judges 10 and verse 14. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen. Let them deliver you in the time of your tribulation. Which we're coming into the time of truth. Hey, Jacob's trouble.
Yep.
All right. I know this brother mentioned Jeremiah 30 earlier.
Jeremiah 30, that's it.
Continuing on. And the children of Israel said unto the Lord, we have sinned. Do thou unto us whatsoever seem good unto thee. Deliver us only. We pray thee this day. Which, you know, I'm going to stop it right there. But that was the main point, man. Jacob has a consistent track record of just serving a golden calf and serving a rock and a fucking tree and all types of stuff. And
that's it. The scripture saying, wood and stone.
Yeah, man. But now, you know, today, why Yahweh Yahusha, he revealed his true name, man. Right. We can glorify him again and call upon his true name.
Mm-hmm.
That the same name that a lot of you people hate.
Yeah. This is Jeremiah 11, verses 11 and 12. Therefore thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon them, which they shall not be able to escape. And though they shall cry unto me, I will not hearken unto them. Verse 12, and shall the cities of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem go, that represents the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, the so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, and cry unto the gods unto whom they offer incense, but they shall not save them at all in the time of their trouble. One of the gods is that voting system. You go to that word vote in the online etymology, you make it's a vow to a god. So if you praying to Donald Trump, and you already had these cats last year talking about niggas with Trump. You got Rick Ross talking about that nigga was eating them. Trump was but that's your God. All right, your politics is your God. Your woman is your God. A woman worship is at an all-time high. Ask your woman to save you in time of trouble. Mm-hmm. Ask these different gods. The great majority of our people in Christianity or Islam. There's a lot of northern tribe Jesus in Islam. Let Allah save you. You know, so that's what the Lord is saying. Cry unto these other gods and ask them to deliver you. All this stuff we talked about previously in this lesson, the pestilence, the civil war. Ask the Lord to deliver you in the time of civil war when Esau is trying to tie you up behind a pickup truck, man. That's what we're telling you. We're installing the fear of the Lord and giving you visuals to paint the picture to be like, look, come back to the Lord or else. Because the Lord has many vast and quick judgments. He's known for his judgments, like he mentions in, I believe it's Isaiah 9:16, if I'm not mistaken. He's known by his judgments. It says in Zephaniah 3:5 that he casts judgments every day. but the unjust knoweth no shame. So that's why we do these live streams, like the brother said. We click the button, we make a simple speech, and then you upload it to the YouTube so people on the other side of the screen can be edified.
Mm-hmm.
I love your job.
The scripture's telling you to do what I believe.
You know what I mean?
We understand too, man. This is our only way of getting out. This is our only way of making it on the chariot, being saved, man. This is our only way of escaping, you know? And you know, a lot of these jakes, you think there's other ways of getting out, but there's no other way, man.
You keep reading that while I get that.
All right. Going back to Deuteronomy 32 in verse 27. It says, and he shall say, where are their gods, their rock in whom they trusted, which did eat the fat of their sacrifices and drank the wine of their drink offerings? Let them rise up and help you and be your protection.
Yeah. So let Jay-Z rise up and be your protection. Let Beyonce call it the beehive. Rise up, bitches. Let her be your protection. Let your dollar bill be your protection. Let Jesus Christ be your protection. You see how far it's going to get you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you.
All right, verse 39, it says, see now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
There you go. Neither is any that can deliver out of my hand. So let's get that precept, which, and you can break this down too. Because it's talking about, like you're saying, they can knife off the Lord.
Yeah.
What the fuck, bro? You think there's another way, and, you know, no, there's only one way. There's only one way to that elevator.
Right.
And,
press
up.
Yeah,
it's
the
only way.
Yeah,
into that elevator and press up.
You know the scripture says, "I'll
be
Christ at thy last end."
Yep. You only go up, but it comes with, you know, the reasonable service. I'm just putting it like that.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know exactly what you mean, bro. That's spot on. Only way is up. The niggas think they go on the ground.
Yeah.
Go left, right. You know, diagonal, southeast.
It's
the only way.
Jay said they can put in the cheat code in life, but there's no cheat code in it, man.
Yeah, this ain't no fucking GTA. Up, down, left, your character.
Yeah, pushing through the wall and shit.
Nah, it's not like that, bro. Jake, this shit is a fucking game, bro.
Yeah.
Quit, stop. When you get copy paste and delete it.
This is Matthew 7:13. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
Mm-hmm.
For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction.
Right. It's A.
Whatever way, other than Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, that you thinking you can escape destruction, that you can escape Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, is going to lead to your death, man. All right. Yeah. There's no other way. Alright, we're clearly playing this day. How about Shin Yahusha is telling you the only way you're gonna make it is through me. Alright? That's what basically point blank period. And we as men of the Lord, we understand that. You know? Alright?
You got it. I got a quick one.
Oh, you got it.
Proverbs 3:7. Be not wise in thy own eyes.
Ooh.
Arise. Fear the Lord and depart from.
That's right, man.
There's another one I think in Proverbs where it said, lean not into thy own understanding.
Yeah, that was two verses above the
one. Yeah, man. That's heavy, man. Because, hey, man, you can't be sitting here thinking you got it all figured out. Because you don't. You really don't. Jake is so simple where he think he got life figured out, man. He think he got the code of life to be able to escape everything. They can put in a cheat code right now and be able to live an eternal life, man. Alright? Hey, man, Jake, your life can be taken at any minute. And the Lord is telling us that, man. That's why, hey, we just read, the Lord can kill and make alive. He the one that's doing all the killing. He's making it known, man.
So I got another quick one for you, because what do we read? Proverbs 3:7, right? So I'm gonna read you Proverbs 3:7 and get you the consequences of being wise in our
minds. That's right.
Proverbs 3:7, be not wise in our minds, fear the Lord and depart from evil. This is Isaiah chapter 5:21. It says, woe unto them. So woe, destruction, war, whatever you want to call it. But it says, woe unto them that are wise in their own eyes and prudent in their own sight. So if you're going to be wise in your own eyes and try to figure out a different escape route or contingency plan to the contingency plan the Lord already laid out, destroy.
Yeah. That's like Jake gathering supplies and food right now, man, you know, thing to prepare for martial law and things of that sort. Thinking y'all ready for the famine, and which, I mean, shoot, hey, the Lord had me set that all up just for the next individual, hopefully, most likely for the elect, yeah. All right, because
you want to know why? Because you got all that prepping shit,
yeah.
All that prep, the provision of flesh, they trust it.
Yeah.
They trust, I'm going to buy all these MREs, meals ready to eat. Mm-hmm. This, right here on me, and this Glock is going to save my life.
Yeah,
they love their life too.
They love their life. That's going to save my life. Mm-hmm. Ain't nothing wrong with prepping.
Yeah, right, yeah.
You ain't got no faith behind it, either. Nah. You don't believe in the Lord, all that's bullshit. Really, you cannot even prep. Mm-hmm. And just believe in the Lord, and you good.
Yeah.
Real talk.
Yeah.
You know,
it comes to mind, too,
man, not to go off target, but you know that show, A Thousand Ways to Die. Yeah. You already seeing that. And Jake being in the comfort of their home, just, you know, dying out, just staying there, just sitting in their house for too long. There's plenty of episodes of A Thousand Ways, but the Lord is going, he's going to dial it up, man. It's going to be, it's going to go from 1,000 to 1,000,000 to 1,000,000,000 ways to die.
That's right. Infinite.
Infinite, yeah.
A nigga going to die by blinking.
Exactly, man.
Nigga sleep, done.
Like that TikTok meme back then with Moabite, which he might have been a Jake, where he say, emotional damage, die, man.
Yeah.
Shoot, we even say it here and there, we might see a crusty Edomite, and he'll cough, and he'll turn up and be like, damn, like, one more cough for him, die again.
Edomite be having
nasty-ass
like,
relax. Slobby cough. Disgusting.
Nasty-ass Edomite. Let's keep going.
I don't have any more.
Okay.
This is Matthew 7:13. Enter ye in at the straight gate. Mm-hmm. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat.
Right, a lot of people are going to take that broad gate, man. A lot of people, that's why I say two-thirds, you know, two-thirds are going to take that broad gate, man, because they take that
MOTB.
Yeah, right, they're going to take the easiest route, and they feel like the MOTB is their way of escaping famine and death and certain things, but that's really what's going to lead you straight to death.
Yeah.
You got it.
Yeah, because the scriptures say, follow not a multitude of believers.
That's right.
And that's what a lot of people are going to do. They're going to follow that line to that station or that stadium.
Mm-hmm.
Because they talk about people prepping. The great majority of people around here, they're not prepping.
Yeah.
They go to Aldi's or, you know, the local food stores and get what they need, their victuals. But when that time comes, they're going to be seeking it through, you know, Esau and his broad way of destruction.
Because everybody has been conditioned to not be self-sufficient.
Yeah.
You know, and then everyone has been conditioned to follow a fucking trend.
Mm-hmm.
And so, oh, I think they're going to the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Maybe I should.
Monkey see, monkey do.
Exactly. Because they're so conditioned to following trends, mm-hmm, and not being self-sufficient and depending on the government to provide the EBT, food stamps, stimulus checks. You know what I'm saying? Instead of having the simple conscience to, man, maybe I should figure out how to make my own this or get into husbandry or just, you know, any little thing. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to be super proficient at it, but just the thought of it. Come on, I'm gonna do this by myself. A lot of people don't have that thought.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, man, I wonder how I can protect myself instead of fucking calling 911.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, man, I got an injury. Maybe I should think about how I can heal myself instead of fucking calling the ambulance for paying $4,000 to be in the front of the back of the ambulance just when the diagnose you with a headache. You fucking idiot. People are going to throw you, though.
Yeah.
Absolutely finished. Is that it?
Verse 14. Matthew 7:14, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
Right, it's gonna be a few, man. It's gonna be a few people that find this way of life, and even maybe to be able to escape, man, from destruction from the ICBM missiles, man. All right, they're gonna be able to escape these, and who those people are? Those are the elect. 144,000 to one third, man. All right, those are gonna be the individuals that escape Esau and the sword, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yeah. So any closing remarks?
I got one. Pull it up. 2 Kings 8:1.
And he answered me, saying,
"The Most High have made this world for many, but the world to come for you." And that, you know, this encapsulates the whole lesson. You know,
mm-hmm.
doing the work. You know, the Lord, because, you know, like we said earlier, you know, how do you expect the Lord to make provisions for you, according to what Isaiah 59:19, you know, if you're not doing his will, if you're not doing his work, it's like going to a job, and you're just slacking off, you're not going to get a paycheck, you're not going to get any accolades, so the Lord commands us to do this work, because if we do, we'll be among the few in the kingdom of heaven, you know, so,
Lord willing,
this lesson was edifying. Once again, first and foremost,
we
give all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son. Double honor to the apostles and elders, the great millstone, the true leaders of Israel who rule well and teach well, and peace, love, and salutations to all you Akim who's pushing this glorious gospel, Yahweh Hashem, Shah. Until next time, Shalom.
Shalom.